I'm going to be talking about a case study in of Silver Bluff Village, which is a skilled nursing home in western North Carolina. Silver Bluff Village and their organization is a third-generation, family-owned and operated long-term health facility. And they got started back in 1963. They have independent living units. They have a 124-bed skilled nursing facility. They have another 20-bed multi-use facility, as well as a child care and some other things. So this is a very unique, active skilled care nursing facility, and very proud of the things that they're doing. And it's my honor to present a recent project of theirs. A couple years ago, there were several needs that they were trying to address. Western North Carolina, and North Carolina really had been in a drought since the late 1990s, and this particular facility is not on municipal water or sewer, and there's no plan for them to receive that. So they're on their own. They had a single well, and they had a wastewater treatment system and a discharge, an NPDES discharge for this facility. So that's a little unique than what we normally see every day working in our municipalities, but I thought that would made for an interesting driver for this particular effort. They decided that they needed to make some upgrades because the viability of their current well was in question. With the droughts, we had many wells going dry through western North Carolina and other places in the state, and they needed to look at the installation of a second well and making sure that they had the right capacity. And they were also being stretched on their wastewater treatment capacity and their discharge permit. At the same time, this 1983 facility really needed to be updated for the resident. So those were some driving factors for the project, with a big focus on water use. So their upgrade included other facility upgrades beyond plumbing. So they addressed the plumbing fixtures, but they also did flooring and painting and lighting at the same time. And there was a moderate expansion of 20 more beds to this 124-bed unit. As a second stage to the project, they also upgraded their water supply by including a backup well, changing pumps, storage tanks, and creating just a more reliable operation. So two significant investments, one on the facility side, one on water and wastewater side. This was done through a design build contract. An architect was engaged to work on that. And so the management communicated very clearly with their design build team that the focus of these upgrades really needed to hone in on water efficiency fixture improvement. So for all the toilets that were replaced, these were upgraded from 3.5 gallon to 1.6 gallon toilets. At that time, the market is really, really emerging right now for high efficiency toilets, so that was not their choice a year and a half ago and 2 years ago when this was designed. Laboratory faucets were upgraded to 0.5 units. Shower heads were upgraded to 1.5 flow, and the commercial laundry equipment was also upgraded. And their approach to this was to talk with their existing vendor service provider, who had a long-term service contract with their current equipment and also handled new equipment. And you know, this is pretty typical of how the decisions would be made across this or many sectors. And so they said, look, what are your most water efficient new units? And the choice of that unit was included water efficiency. So let's look at some of the performance results, and which are really interesting. So they were at a water usage rate for this 124-bed facility at 25,000 gallons per day. And after they were done with the project, they actually had a 20-bed expansion, and they were down to 15,000 gallons per day. So that's a direct 40% reduction. While they were doing this, they identified a approximately 3,500 gallon per day leak that had been disguised by a wet weather spring. So they always thought, well, that's just a spring, but as they did the renovations, they found that that was actually a leak, and they were able to fix that. And now these folks are on their well and their wastewater treatment system, and they don't have an actual quantified cost on every unit of water, but I made an estimate of, on an average water cost for our state, what their water and sewer rate would have cost them and what the savings would have been for the 10,000 gallons a day savings, and it was about $24,500 a year. And so I thought that was very enlightening. The investment, the project investment for the fixture part was about $35,000 for the cost of the fixture upgrade and the labor. So as you can see, you know, that's a really great payback of, you know, a little over, less than a year and a half. So what's interesting on this is, you know, we had talked some about benchmarking, and in this case you could use a benchmarking of a per resident basis. And so before they did anything, their benchmark was about 200 gallons per resident per day. And that's pretty consistent with that number I showed you back in my slide that had, you know, pre-1995 constructed or renovated facilities being at about 190. So you can see how that benchmark is used. Post-project, their use is now down to 164 gallons per, or I'm sorry, 104 gallons per resident per day, and that's kind of close to that 95 gallons as a benchmark that I showed in a previous slide. So you can see how that benchmark really does compare. These are heavy laundry using facilities as well, and so that's why those numbers are so high there. But you know, this was a 40% savings. If we take out the leak, it was still about a 28% reduction in savings there. Other key benefits to this were that they reserved capacity from their wastewater treatment system. So now they have excess capacity there that they can treat more water in case they have an expansion in the future. They're not bumping up on that maximum discharge permit. They have improved operation of the wastewater treatment system because the flows through that system are smaller. And so that served them in many ways. This effort has led to them making interest and investments in other areas, and they have just recently let a contract to install a solar hot water system that will heat hot water for their hot water uses of laundry and kitchen, and they're going forth with that. They're evaluating energy efficiency demand reduction efforts, and have asked us to come out and do an energy audit as well. So, you know, this one effort has led to another, and hopefully many more. So overall, they were really happy with this because all these efforts resulted in a much more reliable, efficient system with equipment and pumps that were more reliable, but also a demand that just was a lot less and gave them a lot more flexibility and room to expand in the future with confidence. So I wanted to share that effort with Silver Bluff Village in Canton, North Carolina.
Okay, thank you, Terry.